morning, cadets. We are talking about today human digestive system. Very simple. Human digestive system means that every animal has a digestive system. For example, different kinds of animal have different kinds of digestive system. In human digestive system, looks like this. First of all, human digestive system divided into two major categories: elementary canal, and digestive glands. Elementary canal means they start with mouth to anus. That complete tube is called elementary canal. This elementary canal divided into majorly five parts. Number one, mouth or cavity. Number two, esophagus. Number third, stomach. Number four, small intestine. And number five, large intestine. So elementary canal divided into five categories. Number one, mouth or vocal cavity. Number two, esophagus. Number three, stomach. Number four, small intestine. And number five, large intestine. And then after, we also have digestive glands. In the human being, majorly three digestive glands. Number one, salivary glands. Number two, liver. Number three, pancreas. So now we study. First one, mouth or vocal cavity. That is the first part of digestive system. Then after, the second part, the food. Start with digestion in mouth. So mouth, then after second one, that is the tube. That is the tube is called esophagus. That is the tube is called esophagus. Then after stomach, that is the stomach. The balloon like structure is stomach. Stomach, which is the part of stomach? Stomach is the end of esophagus and the start of small intestine. In between part is the stomach. That is the stomach. Next, after stomach is small intestine. The small intestine, the end part of the stomach, that is, and the start part of large intestine. That. So in between part, that's tubular structure, quite a different type of shape of structure. That is a small intestine. That is the small intestine. That is the small intestine. That is part of the small intestine. The small intestine again divided into three parts. Number one, the U-shaped part is called duodenum. Duodenum, it's a part of small intestine. Then after duodenum, start with second part, jejunum, it's also a part of small intestine. Then after jejunum, the quite longest part is called this one, ileum, it's also a small intestine part. Small intestine. The small intestine have three parts. Number one, duodenum. Number two, jejunum. Number three, ileum. In the small intestine, we have three parts: duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Then after we start large intestine. Large intestine is that point. That point, start with large intestine. That is the large intestine, complete point. So point cecum. Cecum is a point to connect large intestine and small intestine together. That point is called cecum. That is the cecum. So start with cecum and end with anus. Large intestine also have some parts. Number one, that part is called colon. That part is called colon. It's a part of large intestine. Colon. then after rectum, then after anus. So large intestine also have three parts. Number one, colon. Number two, rectum. Number three, anus. This part is the ascending colon, horizontal colon, descending colon. Then after rectum and anus. So just below the cecum we have a small earthworm like structure, that's why its name is vermiform. Vermi means earthworm like. Vermiform appendix. It's a small vermiform appendix. Usually it's presented ancient type of human being because they digest the cellulose material. So that is the complete structure of digestive system. In the digestive system, we have five steps. Ingestion means taking of food material. Ingestion, taking of food material. Number two, digestion means complex food material converted to simple food material. Number third, absorption. Absorption means the digested food material absorbed by the intestine or bile. Assimilation, absorbed food material mixed into the blood. Assimilation. And digestion means undigested food or non-useful food excreted by the body, exit from the body. So these are the simple steps. Number one, ingestion, intake of food material. Number two, digestion, complex food material converted into simple food material. Absorption, the digested food absorbed by the intestine, small intestine. And assimilation, absorbed food by the small intestine mixed into the blood. Assimilation and undigested food or non-useful food exit from the body. That is called ingestion. It is a simple five steps. So number one, we start with digestion. Digestion is a simple process. So now we start simple one, digestion. Digestion of food. Write down the heading. Digestion of food. So we have carbohydrate. Carbohydrate, then we have protein, and number third we have fat. We have three kinds of food material. So carbohydrate converted to glucose. Protein convert into amino acids. And last one, fat convert into fatty acid and glycerol. Fatty acid and glycerol. So carbohydrate, protein and carbohydrate, protein and fat. So carbohydrate convert into glucose or sugar. In the presence of some kind of enzymes, these enzymes are, number one, carbohydrate convert into glucose, salivary amylase. That is the enzyme responsible for carbohydrate converted to glucose. Next one, protein converted to amino acid with the help of pepsin. And fat converted to fatty acid and glycerol in the presence of lipase. light wave. So that is a simple digestion of food material. It's a 10th level. Digestion of food material, carbohydrate convert into glucose or sugar in the presence of salivary amylase. Protein convert into amino acid in the presence of pepsin enzyme. And fat convert into fatty acid and glycerol in the presence of lipase. So that is process is called digestion. Digestion of food material. It occurs in the usually stomach or small intestine part. Duodenum. The digestion process complete in the stomach and duodenum. Understood? Right now. So that is the simple process. Thank you. If you have any doubt, please tell me.